So Joe, we're back with the consumer unit connected up for us by Luke Wiha mm-hmm. when he came in to see our learners. And today we're going to look at what to do with that consumer's unit, Joe.
So what we're going to do is going to make sure that all of the screw connections inside this consumer unit are done up to the correct torque setting.
Okay.
To achieve that, we're going to use our brand new Wiha torque screwdriver pouch here, which we've bought. And we're going to use this to make sure that every single one of these screws is done up to the correct torque setting. Why is it important that we do that, guys?
The manufacturers set the Newton meters of torque for both the earth bar, neutral bars, the breakers, and the main switch, and we're required to return them to the required torque setting according to the manufacturer. And that the reason behind that is that we don't want excess heat being generated by termination that could be loose and therefore maybe melt the insulation, possibly cause a fire.
Yep.
But equally, we don't want to over tighten them because you can actually create exactly the same problem.
Yeah, absolutely. You can strip the threads on the screw and cause the terminal to fail, which is obviously very undesirable. So I think we'll bring the camera in, we'll have a look at the Wiha pouch, and we'll have a look at the consumer unit.
So Joe, we've got the Wiha pouched screwdriver set now open. Can you go through a few of the elements that are within that set, please?
Yeah, so we've got here the really nice Wiha kit. We've got, you'll notice, two screwdriver handles. We've got just a normal screwdriver handle that we can change the head over on. And then we've also got the all-important and really quite expensive Wiha torque setting screwdriver. So this is the one that we're going to be using to set the torque settings on our terminals. We've also got the torque adjusting tool, which actually helps us to change the torque setting on here. And we've got a variety of screwdriver heads. We've got flats, we've got Phillips, and we've got Pozis. But the one, again, we're going to be using today, the one we're really interested in, are these here. We've got the slotted Pozi screwdriver heads, which are the ones that we should be using to do up our terminals inside our consumer units. And what's really nice about this kit is that you get a Pozi number two, a slotted Pozi number two, and you also get the slightly smaller slotted Pozi number one. So we'll have a little bit of a chat about how we're going to use that in a moment.
Okay then, Joe, so we're ready to do up the terminations here for the top of the main switch. We can clearly see the tails are isolated, they're not connected to anything, so we're not obviously working live, and nor would we. We're going to tighten these up to 2.3 Newton meters of torque. First of all, we've got to set up our Wiha screwdriver. Can you do that for us, please?
Yeah, absolutely. So what we need to do is to set this to the right torque setting. So in order to do that, we need to remove the screwdriver bit holder. So that just simply pulls out of the handle quite easily like that. Then we get our torque setting tool, insert that into the end of the torque handle, and then we twist this around. And in this little tiny window here, we can see what the torque setting will be. So at the moment, we're going to crank this up to 2.3 Newton meters. There's 2.2. We go beyond that. The next one is 2.4. So what we need to do is go halfway between those two. It's not indicated that's 2.3, but it's halfway between 2.2 and 2.4. So that's now set up and ready to go. What we then need to do is put our screwdriver bit holder back inside, just making sure that it's aligned properly, and that will click back into the handle. Select whichever screwdriver bit you're going to be using. So in this case, we're going to use a slotted Pozi number two. Pop that in the end of the screwdriver bit holder, and then just slide up this sleeve here, and that locks the screwdriver bit into the holder.
So Joe, the screwdriver's ready at 2.3 Newton meters of torque. However, before we check that they're at the right torque setting, what are you going to do for me, please?
Well, this might seem a little bit counterintuitive to our viewers, but we're actually just going to undo the screws ever so slightly. These tails have been put in and tightened up, and before I set them to the right torque setting, because this hasn't been done with a torque screwdriver yet, I just want to make sure that they're not all the way tight. The reason for that is that when we select the correct torque setting and do these up to the right value, we're making sure that we're not leaving them too loose, but we're also not making sure that we're doing them up too tight. Now, if somebody had done these up and absolutely hauled on the screw and really got it cranked right up really tight, when I come to put my torque setting screwdriver onto there, what's going to happen is that it's just simply going to register the correct torque setting, even though it might be up 2.5, 2.7, even 3 Newton meters. They could already be done up too tight. So by slacking them off slightly in the first place, when I retighten it now, I know exactly that I'm getting 2.3 Newton meters. So let's just make sure that these are done up to the right value. So there's 2.3 Newton meters. And again. And again. Last one. So now each one of those screws is done up to the torque setting as recommended by the manufacturer.
So that's the main switch done, Joe. Now we've got the RCD within the consumer's unit. What are we going to do now?
So we need to make sure that the manufacturer's connections are tight as well. That's always a good recommendation. So we're going to make sure here that we've got the right torque setting. And again, these are 2.3 Newton meters according to the manufacturer's literature. So once again, just going to make sure that these are at the correct torque setting by slacking them off a little bit and then just tightening them up to the right value. So again, we'll just slacken it off a little bit and then tighten it up to the right value. And you can see this is not a particularly onerous job. This is not taking an awful lot of time. We've just done the main incoming tails, and it's the matter of just a few seconds just to make sure that these are all to the correct value. Obviously make sure that the conductors don't fall out of the terminal. Make sure that they're still in there securely.
And you're doing the bottom of the RCD at the moment as well.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, in fact, actually that one was a little bit loose, so it's a good job that we are checking these. And again, just slacken off ever such a bit and tighten up, and then again, slacken off a little bit and tighten up. So again, within the space of about 30 seconds, we've made sure that all of the manufacturer's terminals are at the correct setting as well, which is quite useful.
So Joe, as we've got it set to 2.3 Newton meters of torque, I think it's worth doing the top of the circuit breakers now at the same time before we have to change the torque settings for the earth and neutral bars.
Yeah, that gives us a little bit of efficiency of time, doesn't it? So again, these have already been tightened up, so we're just slacking them off just a little bit, and then we'll set them up to the right value. So that's now at the right value. We've got a spare way there, so we won't worry about that one. There we go. Just loosen them off just ever so slightly, and then make sure that the torque setting is correct. And again, this is one of those things that when you do it, it doesn't take very long, and you've got the peace of mind of knowing that you've got every single connection inside this board at the right value. So there we go, that's the top row done. So that's every single MCB set to the correct value. And again, we'd just go along the bottom and make sure that we've got the buzz bar on the right setting as well.
Luke, which I'd done a beautiful video for us, a part of the video that he did for connecting this up, where he actually shows us how to make sure that the bar in the bottom of the circuit breakers is obviously connected correctly. Might be one worth watching.
I'm sure the viewers can click an eye somewhere, I guess, I think.
Well, hope so.
Yep.
So this is, like you said, not an onerous task, just a couple of minutes just to confirm these are all back to the manufacturer's Newton meters of torque.
Yep. And for me, this is a very reassuring thing, because I always used to check and double check all of my connections and make sure that all of my terminals were done to the correct values. And having this bit of kit just to make sure that that's all done for you is really reassuring.
So we're almost there, Joe. We've just got to do the earth and neutral bars next, and that is 1.7 Newton meters of torque. So can you just quickly show us how to reset that to that value?
Absolutely. So again, we just slip the screwdriver bit holder out of the end there, pop in our torque setting bar, and we crank this down now to 1.7, which again is somewhere between 1.8 and 1.6. So it'll be about there. So we'll make sure that that's correct. And then what we do is we simply pop the screwdriver bit holder back inside. Now what we're going to do here is when we look at these screws along the top bars here, along the earth and the neutral bars, the screw heads look slightly smaller. And when we plunk this screwdriver in here, it doesn't look like it quite sits properly inside those screws. So what I'm going to do, and what you should really do is when you're doing up all of these types of connection, is make sure that the screwdriver head actually matches up with the terminal. And I think on this particular one, the way I look at it, that these screws need to be done up with a Pozi number one, because the Pozi number two just doesn't seem to quite grip inside there quite as well as it could do. So by using the Pozi number one, we get a slightly better contact. And again, we can go along and make sure that all of these are done up to the correct tightness. So again, just a slight slackening off, and then re-tighten to the correct value.
And when you say that's a Pozi one, that's a slotted Pozi one. It's the one designed to go in this style of screw. Is that right, Jack?
That's correct, yep. Sometimes these are referred to as plus minuses.
again, slackening off, tightening up, 1.7 newton meters of torque as required by the manufacturer. It's exactly the same for the earth bar as is the neutral bar. Joe's working his way down.
Absolutely, and you'll notice as I've gone along as well, again, I've checked the manufacturer's connections on this bar to the correct torque setting as well. And we're approaching the end of the CPCs now.
I know there's a big call that you allow the connections, Joe, to settle down. Maybe you give them a little pull and a tug and then you revisit these termination tightness. Again, that's electrician's preference. I think we're trying to reiterate the point of setting it to the required torque setting. Yep. And if you want to go back afterwards just to give them that final tweak, I think it would, wouldn't be bad practice to do so.
And there we go. And that earth conductor there was not as tight as it could have been, so we've made that right up to the correct tightness now. So again, you know, we've done an introduction, we've tightened up all of these connections, and all in all that has not been a very long task, and we've got the peace of mind now of knowing that all of these terminals are done up to the correct torque setting.
So Joe, we're going to revisit this consumer unit a few more times. In the future, we're going to talk about AC RCDs and A-type RCDs and the pros and cons of using each of those. Mm-hmm. We're also going to look, Joe, at the stickers, some of the stickers that we're going to have to put on the consumer unit before we leave.
Yep.
This video concentrated on, Joe?
This video concentrated on making sure that we've got the right torque setting on all of the terminals inside here. So every single one of these screws now is done up to the manufacturer's recommended setting.
We also worked between the slotted Pozi 2 and the slotted Pozi 1, depending on whether we were on the earth bar, neutral bar, or actually...
Absolutely. And again, this is one of those things, you've got to look at the screw head and match it up to the screwdriver bit, yeah? And make a judgment call on whether you think it's going to be a number 2 or whether you think it's going to be a number 1. Just make sure you get that absolutely spot on.
So, I think it's time, Joe.
Should we do it?
We hope this video has been some help.